My assistant, Gopher, will demonstrate the formation using my tornado simulator ZX9, which lets us observe a tornado in 100% complete safety. Gopher, if you please. When wind near the ground moves in one direction, and wind above it moves in a different direction, it can form a horizontal tube of spinning air. Meanwhile, in the clouds, the condensation that makes rain and hail gives off heat, which makes air near the ground move upward. As this air moves upward, it tilts the horizontal tube of spinning air to an upright position. This upright spinning tube of air can then fall hail, rain, dirt, and other things into it. And when this tube stretches from the cloud to the ground, a tornado is formed. These storms can have huge dark clouds, lightning, thunder, large hail, and strong winds. Gopher, what have you done to my tornado simulator?
And that's how tornadoes form.
Hello? Mr. Pow, are you there? Come in!
Oh, Beep. Thank goodness you're back. I can't stop thinking about that tractor that got sucked straight to the sky!
Don't worry, Mr. Cow. I've got your answer. I know how tornadoes form.
Oh, I feel safer already. What do you got for me?
Well, tornadoes start to form when winds blowing in opposite directions create a horizontal tube of spinning air.
Okay, tube of air. Got it. What's next?
When rain and hail form in the clouds, it generates heat, which can cause the tube of spinning air to tilt upwards towards the sky.
Oh, okay. So a tube of air starts tilting upward because of the heat.
And if the top of the tube touches the storm cloud and the bottom touches the ground...
That's how tornadoes form!
You got it!
Oh, thank you, Beep! But to be honest, I'm still a bit of a nervous wreck.
Are you still thinking about that tractor getting sucked up into the sky?
No. Now I'm thinking about it coming down. On me!